He plays his flute in order to enliven the hearts of many devotees. He is the only friend of the suffering living entities. When he plays his flute, all the cows and other animals of Vrindavan, although engaged in eating, simply take a morsel of food in their mouths and stop chewing. Their ears raise up and they become stunned by that beautiful melody of Krishna's flute. They do not appear alive but like painted picture animals. Krishna's flute playing is so attractive that even animals become enchanted, and what to speak of ourselves. We worship Govinda, whose neck is round, whose neck bears a swinging pearl of necklace, who is always there in times of need, who is always graceful, who is known as Tribhanga Lalita Shyamalam, the one who is Keshava, the one who is Madhava, the one who is Shyamasundar, the one who manifests himself, the one who spoke the Bhagavad Gita on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. To that Bhagavan Krishna, we all bow and pay reverence to. Om Shri Ganeshaya Namaha. Om Shri Saraswatiya Namaha. Om Shri Guru Charana Kamalabhyo Namaha. Om Namaha Shivaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Vakratun Namahataya Surya Koti Samabhribha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarvakayeshu Sarvada. Our salutations to Ganesha, to Dambodharaya, who has a large body and whose splendor is similar to millions of suns. O Ganesha, please make all of our undertakings free of obstacles. You are known as Avighna, the one who removes obstacles. O Ganesha, we bow to you.
Veeradhare Vipulamangaladanashile Bhaktartirashini Viranchi Harishavande Kirti Prade Akiromanuratade Mahadev Vidya Pradayani Saraswati Nami Nityam Narayanam Namaskrityam Naranchaiva Narotamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayam Udhirate Shrivadam Svakataha Krishna Punyam Shravana Kirtana Hride antaha spyohiya bhadrani vibhyoti sprutharsadam Yam brahma varunindra rudra marutaha Sturavanti divyastave Virayasanga padukranishade Gayanti samadaha Jnanavastita talagatena manasa Pashyanti yam yogino Yasyatamna vidhu surasura gana Devaya tasvayamaha Akanda mandala karam Vyaptam yena characharam Tatpadam darshitam yena Tasvayashri guruve namaha Hari Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti Hari
Om. We all join very beautifully in the Havan. Havan is very important. Everyone please say Swaha as loud as possible.
Om Shri Keshavaya Namaha Narayanaya Namaha
Swaha
Madhave Namaha
Swaha
Govinde Namaha
Swaha
Vishnave Namaha
Swaha
Madhusudanaya Namaha
Swaha
Trivikrame Namaha
Swaha
Om Vishnave Namaha
Swaha
Om Keshavaya Namaha
Swaha
Om Madhave Namaha
Swaha
Om Kindashraya Namaha
Swaha
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Namaha
Swaha
Om Vishnave Namaha
Swaha
Om Namo Hari Swaha
The Gayatri Mantra three times
Om Hare Bhuma Swaha Tatsani Kare
session of this Bhagavat Mahapuran Yajna. And from session 1 to 4, we have been dealing with the Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran. And after every Yajna, the final day, the Sampur, it is very necessary to delve deep into the pages of the Bhagavad Gita. So today I will do that. But before we delve into the Bhagavad Gita, we chant very beautifully the Gita Dhyanam. Verses that praise the Gita, we pray.
Pārthāya pratibhoditam bhagavata nārāyaṇena svayam vyāsena grapitam purāṇa munina madhye mahābhāratam advaitam amritam varshani bhagavati aṣṭādaśadhyāyaṇe ammātvā manusangatāmi bhagavad-gītē dvadeśane namastu te vyāsa viśāla buddhim Kulāra-vṛndāyata patra-netra Yena-tvaya-bhāyata-taila-purna Prajvālito-jñāna-vaya-pradevaha Sarvo-paniṣadu-gāvo-dhokta-gopāla-nandana Pārtu-vatsa-sudhir-bhokta Gokta-gītāṁ-prihata Vasudeva-sutam-devam Kamsa-chāru-yaparganam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagat Guru Bhishma Drona Tata Jaya Mrita Chala Gandhara Nilota Pala Shaila Grahavati Kripena Varni Karnena Vila Kulaha Ashtama Vikrama Ghora Makara Duryodhana Vardhani
Sotiranotaropanamai Rangira kevaka kleshava Parashayo vachara rajo Malamangrita kalam Nanayakam desham harikatha Sambhodana Loke sanja shakuna dhariha Piya manisha mudha Vyayodha bharata pankajam Kalvita naha shriyase Mokam karo diva chalam Pangum lengayte bhir Yatribata maham vande
If Bhagavan Krishna manifests into rock, it is known as Giriraj. If he manifests into land, this is Vrindavan. If he manifests into the living guidance, it is the Guru, it is the Acharya. If he manifests into sound, it is the holy name Krishna. And if he manifests into literature, it is the Srimad Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavat Mahapurana. And today, my dear brothers and sisters, we will look at one person called Arjuna. Today, I have chosen Arjuna to speak on. I could have chosen anyone else, Dhritarashtra, Sanjaya, or even Bhagavan Krishna. But today I want to choose Bhagavan Arjuna for a simple reason, that we are all Arjuna. Confused and confusing. Having the Lord with us, but still being very weak. We will do an in-depth analyzation of Arjuna. With the limited amount of time that I have, I will try my best. We will see where Arjuna went wrong, my dear brothers and sisters. And we begin very beautifully with the birth of Arjuna. Kunti, in the presence of King Pandu, asks Indra Bhagawan for a son, for a child. Evam pratyam agyanascha vani ata jaga madhye Indra janiye mascha Arjunam. Kunti is blessed with a child. And at the birth of the child, everyone is excited, my dear brothers and sisters. Usually when a child is born, they're taken into a room full of babies. And all the babies, they look alike, wrapped in a white sheet. And you can't tell them apart. But when Arjuna was born, my dear brothers and sisters, this was not the case. You could tell him apart. Karda Vidya Samaskunti Shivatulyam Parakrama. This baby had the equivalent strength of Kartike and the bravery of Bhagawan Shiva and the handsomeness of Bhagawan Vishnu. He was born in the month of Phalgun, so he got the name Phalguna. Now this Phalguna, he started maturing and he acquired the guru of Drona Acharya. And as time went on, Phalguna received the name Arjuna. Arjuna means the one who can think very clearly, the one who is very decisive. Once, Arjuna's guru, Drona Acharya, wanted to test his students. So he placed all of them in a forest to do what? To see who can describe the forest the best. And the guru put a bird on top of the most tallest tree and told his students to tell me back what you see in the forest. No one did not see the bird. Only Arjuna was the one who saw that bird. He was the best disciple. Now Arjuna, after completing all his studies and many family problems came later, he finds himself in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, fighting for his life, fighting against the unrighteous people. Arjuna is the warrior on the chariot, and Bhagavan Krishna is the one steering the chariot. Now, we know who Arjuna is, but what is this Bhagavad Gita? What is this Gita? G-I-T-A, God's instruction to all. Bhagavad Gita is made of 18 chapters. The first chapter, when somebody picks up this Bhagavad Gita, they skip the first chapter, and they go from chapter 2 to chapter 18, because the chapter 1 is very long. It's very boring. It doesn't even have Bhagavan Vach. Bhagavan does not even speak in the first chapter. People start from chapter 2. But chapter 1 is the most important chapter. Why? Because the problem came from chapter 1.
We want to find the solution, 2 from 18, but we don't even know the problem yet. Chapter 1 builds a very strong foundation, and it is one of my favorite chapters, although very hard to digest, because first we hear from a blind king, the first verse of the Bhagavad Gita from a blind king. Why is a blind king speaking? And then it moves on to whole family problems, and we skip it and we go from chapter 2 to 18. But chapter 1 lays out the problem for us. And Arjuna did something wrong in chapter 1. And that is why he wasn't able to fight. And sometimes we also do this wrong thing. We see that in chapter 1, Arjuna instructed Bhagavan, Krishna, to take him in the middle of the battlefield. And Bhagavan Krishna didn't say a word. He let Arjuna do what he wanted. And he took Krishna in the middle of this battlefield. So now when he went into the middle of the battlefield, then he saw his enemies. And this is where he messed up, my brothers and sisters. We feel we are big enough to make our own plans and make our own decisions. Arjuna says, "Hey God, take me there." But it's the other way around. We have to ask Bhagavan to come and to guide us and to tell us what to do. We cannot tell Bhagavan what to do. Bhagavan, take us in the middle of the battlefield. And then Krishna did. He didn't say, "Arjuna, you can't do this." He took him, and then this is where all the problems started, my dear brothers and sisters. So we cannot command God. God commands us. We take shelter from Him. Our plans, we make our plans, and we say, "Bhagavan, just say Tatastu, and we will do the rest." So Arjuna is taken on the other side. And now Arjuna is a very virtuous person, very brave. Remember, we saw he was the only one who saw the bird on the top branch. He was very skillful, very courageous and wise and virtuous. But how does Arjuna react to this battlefield, my dear brothers and sisters? How does he respond? Bhagavad Gita beautifully says,
Govinda, Govinda, Bhajule, Gopala, Gopala, Bhajule, Govinda, Govinda, Bhajule, Gopala, Gopala, Bhajule, Govinda, Govinda, Bhajule, Gopala, Gopala, Bhajule, Krishna Yuta Tumma Samutpati Tamsidha Bhavada Trimukam Cha Bukam Cha Paivayati Veda Krishna Sharire Mero Maharsha Chacha Ita Gandhi Vantam Kayata Yasta Bhavam Cheva Paridhaya Nacha Shanko Diya Vastum Brahma Diva Chivinda Nakarche Hidayam Krishna Nachara Kutkacha Hindu Raj Govinda Himbho Jire Jiva Govinda Govinda
to be a very energetic person when he sees his battlefield, my dear brothers and sisters. He was well molded to be a warrior, and we would expect him to fight for his dharma. But my dear brothers and sisters, this is not it. Arjuna's heart is filled with deep pity. His body is shivering. His mouth is drying up. His hair on his body are standing. His limbs are shaking and quivering. His bow, which makes all evil shake, drops from his hands. His mind is in confusion. And he can't stand anymore, So he falls down. Is this the Arjuna we know? When we think of Arjuna, a clear picture of a brave hero comes to mind. Long and mighty arms with bow and arrows in hands. Big eyes with these huge arms to defeat everything unrighteous. But he's not in this state at this moment, my dear brothers and sisters. Why? Because he thought he was in control. He thought he was in control. And when we think we're in control, we fail, my dear brothers and sisters. There is a higher power above us. A higher power above us. He made the instruction to God to go in the middle. Bhagavan took him in the middle and he collapsed. If he never made that instruction to Bhagavan Krishna, he would have stayed on this side and he would have fought. But he went closer. He saw the other side. He saw his family and his friends. But they were all adharmic. They were all unrighteous. And Bhagavan makes it very clearly that we have to stand up for our dharma. So now he says, "Hey Krishna, save me." And what does Krishna say? What does Arjuna say to Krishna?
Karpanya dosho artapasva bhava prichyama tvam dharma samudha chetaha yachcheya sanchit bruhi tamme shishyaya
Hey Krishna, please save me. I am confused about my duty, O Krishna. I am besieged with anxiety and faint-heartedness. I am your disciple, O Krishna. I surrender to you. Hey Krishna, please save me, Krishna. Instruct me what to do, O Krishna. I am confused about my duty, O Krishna. I am filled with anxiety. I do not know what to do, O Krishna. Please save us. Save me, O Krishna. Arjuna says to Krishna. Raksha karo, Bhagavan. Raksha karo. I see the other side and I do not know what to do, hey Krishna. Hey Krishna, please save me. What do I do, O Krishna? My limbs are shaking. My mouth is dry, O Krishna. My bow fell from my hands, O Krishna. What do I do? And when Bhagavan Krishna heard this, my dear brothers and sisters, he smiled.
Now we have to analyze something. Arjuna approached Bhagavan Krishna with three different aspects. Number one, he says, Krishna, I am nothing. I want to move, but I want you to move my chariot. I want you to steer my life. Second, Krishna, I need your help. I don't even know what the problem is. How can I know the solution? And third, we have to be sincere, gentle, and humble to go to Bhagavan. And we cannot treat Bhagavan like a pill. Only when we have a headache, then we go for the ibuprofen bottle. When the headache is gone, forget about the ibuprofen. We cannot treat Bhagavan like this. And Krishna, Bhagavan Krishna gave Arjuna 18 curry in the form of the Bhagavad Gita. Dongsis later will have 7 curry prepared by our Pitaji here. Once you go curry, you don't have to worry. So the Bhagavad Gita was spoke on a battlefield, not in a temple, not in some sort of cave or some sort of sacred place, on a huge big battlefield where people have swords and bows and arrows and all sorts of weapons and the conch shell is blowing. So noisy there. Why? Our life is a complete battlefield, my dear brothers and sisters. If Bhagavan Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita in a cave, we would say, oh, my life is not a cave. He was in a different circumstance. My life is a complete battlefield right now. So Bhagavan Krishna says, okay, your life is a battlefield. I will speak it in a battlefield. Why did he speak it in the battlefield? Because we listen to Bhagavad Gita to be victorious in everyday battles that we have in our lives. Some people say, I will be a devotee, a bhakta, when all my problems vanish. But think about this. If you're at the beach and you say, I'm going to go inside of the water when the waves stop. Let me tell you something, you're never going to go in that beach. The waves will keep on coming back and forth.
These waves are like problems. Problems will constantly come in our lives. People can't wait for problems to vanish to go over to the bhakti side. People have to go to bhakti to make their problems disappear, my dear brothers and sisters. For example, it's raining very heavily outside. There was huge, big rain clouds. There is the rain. We cannot stop the rain from falling, but we can take out an umbrella and stop ourselves from getting wet from the rain. Similarly, this cloud represents Kali Yuga, the age that we are currently in. Problems will always come from this cloud, my dear brothers and sisters. But we can't stop the problem. So what do? We take out the shield, the Bhagavad Gita, that umbrella, and we protect ourselves from these problems. This is very symbolic, my dear brothers and sisters. So now Arjuna turns to Bhagavan Krishna and says, Prabhu, is it worth killing all these people just for a piece of land? And Bhagavan Krishna looks at the very depressed Arjuna and says these very potent, powerful words. What does he say?
Hari Sundara Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari O Hari Sundara Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari O.
Krishna says, hey Par, hey Kuntiputra, hey Dayananda Jaya, hey Pandava, hey Arjuna, hey Panduputra, hey Kshatriya, rise and fulfill your dharma, rise and live up to your duty. It is your duty to defend the righteous and eliminate the unrighteous. And when Arjuna heard this, he was still not convinced. It took him many more chapters for him to be convinced. Arjuna says, Na yotsva iti govindam. Na yotsva iti govindam. Hey Govindam, the very thought of war itself gives me grief and I feel very dejected. Therefore, I will not fight. And Bhagavan Krishna says, Ashochan vachyotyam prayadhansha bhayasa gatasun ghatascha nana shadhanti panditaha. Ye Arjuna, your grief for those who should not be grieved for, and yet speak like a wise man, but the wise men do not grieve for the living or the dead. Arjuna still not convinced. He says, Nibitanti cha pashyami viritranti keshava. Hey Keshava, wherever I look, I see nothing but evil and unpleasant omens in the upcoming battles. Krishna looks at him and smiles and says, Yaha sarivartran vishethat tat prapya shubham. A karma yogi does not care for omens. He is unattracted to everything. Therefore, he neither rejoices when meeting pleasant circumstances, nor does he ever feel dejected if he encounters any unpleasant events. Arjuna, still not convinced. He says, in this battle, I do not foresee any good resulting from any the slaughter of my friends and relatives. Krishna says, sarva dharma pi chakshivya na vipam tu ma arasi. There is nothing more welcome to a warrior than a righteous war. Arjuna, your duty is to fight the unrighteous people. And Krishna, he profoundly makes this point very clear that we all should stand up for our dharma. And 18 chapters went on, my dear brothers and sisters, of convincing Arjuna that he should get up, he should pick up his bow, and he should fight. And I want to present to all of you 7 pearls of the Bhagavad Gita. The first gem, the first pearl of the Bhagavad Gita is you have the right to work, but never the fruits of that work. Action thy duty, reward not thy concern. Karmeni radhika raste ma phalishu kadachana ma karma pala hetur bhur mate sangosva karmani. We have the right to work, but not the right, the fruits of that work. He says, second, change is the law of the universe. You can be a billionaire, and be a pauper in just a few seconds, in an instant. This reminds me once, a very poor man went to a millionaire and said, how did you become a millionaire? What's your secret? He said, sir, my wife. First, I was a billionaire, and she made me into a millionaire. This third quality is you came empty-handed and you will leave empty-handed. What you will take is your bag of your karma, your good deeds, your punyas and your papas. Another gem of the Bhagavad Gita is man is made by his belief. As he believes, so will he be. For example, you have a headache. You go to the doctor. As soon as you see the doctor, the headache gone. Or that doctor can only give you a glass of water to drink, regular glass of water, and your headache is gone. But if somebody else who's not a doctor gives you a glass of water, the headache will still be there. Because you know he's a doctor, he knows what he's doing, and you believe that if you drink this water, the headache will be gone. And so it happens, my brothers and sisters. Another gem of the Bhagavad Gita is when meditation is mastered, the mind becomes like a stable fire in a very windy place. Meditation is very important. When we can control the mind and control the senses, it is very important. Start by controlling thirst and your hunger. I find it very hard to do sometimes, because you get so hungry, you just want to eat. And in about a couple of hours, I'm going to break my salt food fast. I'm waiting for that to come. So, Bhagavan Krishna, he makes yoga very, very important. Practice, self-control and sense control. And these are the gems of the Bhagavad Gita. Another gem of the Bhagavad Gita is your mind is your best friend and your mind is your worst enemy. You see, I came late today. My mind was being my enemy and told me to sleep 5 minutes more. Then the alarm ring, 5 minutes more, 5 minutes more, 5 minutes more. If my mind was my best friend, I would have woke up. But the mind will discourage you and encourage you. So once we control the mind, we can control the mind and tell the mind to always encourage us. So learn to control the mind. The mind is the best friend and the worst enemy. Now before I conclude, I would like to chant these very beautiful shlokas. And these shlokas, my brothers and sisters, they tell us the qualities of a pure devotee, of a true devotee. And you look at chapter 12 of the Bhagavad Gita, as Bhagavan Krishna makes these very beautiful statement. He describes the qualities of a pure devotee, of a true devotee, you see.
Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Murari Yadavasudeva
Has no hatred for anyone, who is friendly and compassionate to all, who cares for all, who is a kind friend to all, who is very tolerant, who is always satisfied, the one who is always self-controlled, that person is dear to me.
Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Murari.
The one who is content and satisfied, steady in meditation, self-controlled, and possess a firm conviction in the need of their mind, that person is the only one.
Shri Krishna Govinda
Hare Murari, Hare Nath Narayan Vasudeva.
Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Murari,
Hare Nath Narayan
Vasudeva. Yes, Bhagavat Jate Loko, Loka Loto Jate Chaya, Harata Marasa Mayode, Deku Mukto Mahatriya. Do we go to Vrindavan to find Krishna? Do we go to India to find Krishna?
We find Krishna right in you, my dear brothers and sisters. Krishna is right in all of us.
When you're peaceful, that's the Krishna in you. When you help an elderly person, that's the Krishna in you. When you do puja, that's the Krishna in you.
Now, I know Bhagavad Gita has 18 chapters, and each chapter, there's a nice line that tells you what it talks about. The first chapter deals with Bhagavan is always in command and always listen to him. Second chapter deals with right knowledge is the ultimate solution to all problems. The third chapter, selflessness is the only way to make progress and prosperity. Number four, every act can be an act of prayer. Whatever you do, make it an act, make it a prayer to Bhagwan. 5. Renounce the ego. One, we are born into this world and one day we will exit. What's the point of having ego? Always be humble, my brothers and sisters. 6. Connect to the higher consciousness daily. Talk to Bhagwan, talk to him, and he will guide you. 7. Practice what you learn. Live what you learn. Number 8. Never give up on yourself. Never ever give up on yourself. Everyone is born with a spark of God and anything is possible with Bhagavan. Number 9 is to value your blessings. Like the man without foot looks at the man with foot and says, I want foot. The man with the foot looks at the man with socks and says, I want socks. The man with socks looks at the man who has shoes and says, I want shoes. Always value your blessings.
number 10, is to see divinity all around, my dear brothers and sisters. Everyone is a spark of God. That same energy is within everyone. Number 11, have enough power to surrender and see the truth. Accept defeat sometimes. Number 12 is to absorb your heart and mind in the Supreme Lord. Number 13 is detach from Maya. A couple of days ago, we saw the Leela of Gajendra. Oh, he was in the jaws of the crocodile. He was stuck into Maya. Detach yourself from Maya and attach to the Divine. He's the master of Maya, the one who controls Maya. Number 14, live a lifestyle that matches your vision. 15, give priority to the divinity. 16, being good is a reward itself, my dear brothers and sisters. Number 17, choosing what is right over what is pleasant is a sign of power. Choosing what is right over what is pleasant. Sometimes a wrong thing will be pleasant too. So we have to choose what is right. And 18, let go and move to the union with Bhagavan. Now I know today we celebrate the birthday of Pitaji Surrenderji, and I have a quote for you and anyone who else celebrated their birthday today. Forget the past, for we can't change it. Forget the future, we can't see it. And forget the present, because I forgot to bring one for you. I'm so sorry I forgot to bring a present, but tomorrow definitely I will give you a present, and anyone who has celebrated their birthday.
That's your biggest present. What you're doing, I'm just happy.
It's birthday. So, shall we all clasp our hands, bow our heads?